All right, Jolin. Let's talk a little bit about tree diseases. And there've been a lot of diseases this year because of the
cool, wet spring. Yes. Cool, wet weather in the spring is one of the number one causes of the increase in tree diseases.
I can definitely believe that. In this area, we've had cool, wet weather.
Yes.
In the spring.
And it has been, for us personally, it's been pleasant for people, but the trees are suffering a little bit because
that's
of
right.
it.
That's right. So let's start with the first common tree disease, which is anthracnose.
Anthracnose.
Okay.
This is a fungus that affects a lot of deciduous and evergreen trees. There are different types of fungi that actually attack and cause anthracnose.
Okay.
And it's different for, you know, certain trees will get certain types of the fungus that causes the anthracnose. You know, you want to see what it looks like? Well, you know, it starts with black spots and areas on the leaves. And sometimes it'll carry itself through to the stems and down the branches to, you know, the main trunk. Or another main branch. And the best thing to do is when you start seeing that, to cut it out as soon as possible, because then don't put that in the compost pile. Put that in a garbage and throw it away because you don't want those spores to stay around to infect
the tree again. Right, because those spores are still
there. They're still there.
Right.
Yes. Mm. Yeah. High humidity also can cause anthracnose. So that's why in the fall, sometimes once we start getting cool weather, you'll start seeing anthracnose also on your trees.
Yeah.
Fungicides can work, but remember, you're talking about a tree. And it's kind of hard to spray a large tree. And I would get a professional to do that if you just really want to. But anthracnose usually doesn't affect the whole tree unless you just don't do anything about taking out the dead parts.
Right.
And
it,
like I said, cut out the dead parts as soon as you see them, and that will throw away those spores so they don't keep infecting the tree or other trees around it.
Right. So practice good sanitation, right?
Very good scent. And when the leaves fall in the fall season, collect them.
Yeah.
But don't put them in the compost pile because they may be infected with that.
Okay. All right. So that's anthracnose.
Anthracnose.
All right.
Then we've got bacterial leaf scorch. Now that's mostly of oak trees. The pin oak being the worst. In fact, pin oaks are so bad with leaf scorch disease that we don't even recommend pin oaks anymore because they're just so affected by this disease. Again, it's a bacteria this time that affects the xylem of the system of the tree, which is where the nutrients all flow up and down the tree.
Right.
Once the tree gets this, it's just a very slow process and it will always take over the tree. There's no cure for bacterial leaf scorch. You can keep the tree as healthy as possible for as long as possible, and some people will even have a tree company come in and put antibiotics into the tree.
Wow. Okay.
But that's very expensive and has to be done all the time, and it's just going to slow down the inevitable, which is when this bacteria just takes over the xylem of the entire tree and will just take it out.
Wow. And the thing about the leaves, it actually looks like it's been burned by a torch.
Yes.
So bacteria.
Yeah, not that the whole leaf gets brown. It can be just parts of the leaf that turn.
Wow.
And it can be different sections of the tree. It could be a top section or a lower section or a quarter of the tree. It's very interesting how it affects, but it's the xylem. It's affecting the xylem on that particular side of or part of the tree.
Yeah, which takes water.
Yeah.
Up to those leaves. How about that?
The next one is oak leaf blister. And that's where you see these raised, it's a fungus, and you see these raised areas that can be almost 2 inches in diameter on an oak leaf. And a lot of people say, oh, what is this? That is what it is. They'll become yellowish and brownish, and they'll be concave on the leaf, wet, cool springs again. But, you know, maintaining plant vigor is important with this disease because it's cyclical. Some years will be worse than others depending on the weather. It's very dependent on the weather with cool springs. The next thing you need to think of is when those spores are out there, you really don't treat for them. And it rains, they'll splash spores, but they get on the buds of the tree and it overwinters there.
Right.
So
when it leaks out.
It rains and they spread out to the leaves. So
are we talking fungal or bacteria?
This is a fungus.
Okay, so it's a fungus, good.
Yeah.
Okay.
And sometimes It really doesn't seriously affect the tree. Some years are worse than others, but you can do one application of chlorothalonil and in the spring as the buds are bursting, and it will control it better.
Okay.
But still, you're talking about a tree.
Yeah, we're talking about a tree. So again, you know, certified arborist.
Yes, sir, definitely certified arborist.
You want somebody to come out and assess the plant health.
Yeah. Keep it healthy.
Keep it healthy.
Okay. Water and drought. Next, shothole disease.
Oh my goodness. All those shothole diseases, right?
Okay. These cause brown spots on the leaves, usually of the prunus species, the plums, the cherries, the laurels. And what happens is the inside of the little hole that turns brown, it then dies.
Mm-hmm.
And then you see little holes.
Yeah, because that tissue falls out.
Yeah, right, the tissue falls out. And you've got, so that's why it looks like somebody's shot.
Yeah, buckshots.
Buckshot through the tree, but that's not really what it is. again, this is favored by wet, cool weather. it's an ongoing story. Air circulation. That's one thing about these. If you've got a cherry tree that's in amongst a bunch of other trees, you need to make sure there's enough air movement and prune it away. And then also the tree itself, the canopy itself needs to have air circulation through it. So
that's a good point.
The more air circulation you get, the less you'll have of the shothole disease.
Right.
You can spray it, but it would be a regular spray program. You can't just spray it once. And because all fungicides are mostly preventative and not curative.
That's right.
So you have to have a program of spraying fungicide on it. And there's a lot of places I know that have lots of cherry trees, and they want that's their signature. They have a company, certified arborists, come in and spray regularly for this disease on these cherry trees and other plums and things like that.
Because they will get that disease. And again, practice good sanitation
if
those leaves fall.
Yeah, definitely.
Right.
Powdery mildew.
Yeah, saw a lot of that this year.
Again, cool, wet springs is caused by kind of being a white or a grayish fungus that grows on the new growth, especially. Dogwood trees are especially susceptible to it. Again, wet, cool weather in the spring and sometimes the fall also. Good air circulation again, because you think about it, dogwood trees and are in as shade under the shade of other trees.
They're understory trees.
Yeah, so you know you've got to have air circulation in there. You got to think about these things, prune them away from each other, make sure the dogwood has some air circulation in through the leaves, and irrigation systems that keep throwing water on the trees. Try not to have that happen, because that's just going to increase the chance of it getting powdery mildew. But most importantly, get species that are resistant to it.
Yeah. Resistant varieties.
There are resistant varieties to a lot of these, to anthracnose and to a lot of these others, the diseases we're talking about. But you have to look for the newer varieties that say they're resistant to some of these.
Sure. And let's make sure we cover this because we're saying air circulation a lot. So what do we mean by that?
Air circulation. Yeah, you've got to have space between your tree. You're going to see air and light between your trees. And then in the tree, you don't want a dense canopy. You want dappled shade. So you want to be able to see some shade and some sun come through the tree.
Okay.
And then you'll know you have enough air circulation around it so that the leaves don't stay continually wet all the time.
Right. You want those to dry out.
You want everything to dry out.
That's right. Okay. Good, good.
And the last thing we've got is cankers.
Yeah.
And you know what? This is the sad part about cankers. Cankers are mostly our fault. Because it's mechanical problems that start the
canker. I hadn't thought about it like that.
Cankers are mostly our fault.
Yeah.
Because we've run into them with something.
Yeah, lawnmowers, weed eaters.
Something.
Yeah, something, yeah.
And it causes a dark section to form on the wound.
Right.
Well, you know, some cankers can, you know, the tree can outlive itself and close over that wound that you've created. As long as it's not too much of the percentage of the round, the base of the tree.
Okay.
There are some canker diseases that when they get in, it's a death sentence. And that's like hypoxylin canker, chestnut blight, cytospora. All of those are, when they get in, there's no saving the tree.
Right, because it makes it hard for the water and nutrients to get around that area, right, mm-hmm. where that canker is to get up to the upper canopy.
It does.
Yeah. Yeah, how about that?
And sometimes you'll see a canker and then the leaves and stuff, will, branches will die because it's not getting the nutrients and water that it needs. Yeah.
Exactly.
But keep trees, if you've got that problem, just keep trees as healthy as you can.
Okay. Healthy as you can, right? Because we want those trees to look good, not awful.
Yes, that's right.
All right. Thank you, Joanna. I appreciate that. Good information.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please click the subscribe button below.